Smith. Oh, you got me. It's over. Come on.
Finish it, Ferg.
Come on.
Finish that shit.
Stop playing, nigga.
Before, Kimbo Slice would return to mixed martial arts after a 5-year hiatus, signing a multi-bout deal with Bellator MMA.
Man, listen, dude, sure. I'm a manhandler, you dude.
Yeah.
I promise you that.
Before the charismatic newcomer's loss to Seth Petruzelli in only 14 seconds marked the end of Elite XC. YouTube's favorite bare-knuckle boxer would parlay his online popularity into global stardom as an MMA fighter.
It's still amazing to me, man. Yeah, you know, I like watching it, you know what I'm saying? I get turned on by myself.
Before you could make $100 by taking one of his famous right hooks.
I'm ready.
Oh! 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 Shit! Oh!
Wow, I don't care how hard up you are for money, taking a punch like that is not worth it.
Oh. Oh. Man.
Now, young Kimbo Slice, then known as Kevin Ferguson, was a skilled linebacker who aspired to play in the NFL. But after having those dreams squashed by Hurricane Andrew, he found himself living out of his car and in trouble with the law. Hard up for money, he turned to a world of underground street fighting, which would eventually take him all the way to the UFC. With an estimated net worth of $1 million, but tragedy would strike again when on June 6, 2016, Kimbo Slice died tragically at the age of only 42. I'm Amber Smith, documenting the life of Kimbo Slice prior to his passing, here for you on Before They Were Dead. Now, at the time of this recording, Kimbo's death is still very new. Please leave your condolences for his family in the comment section down below.
It's a profession, it's a sport, it's entertainment, and I enjoy kicking ass.
Kevin Ferguson was born in Nassau in the Bahamas on February 8, 1974, but grew up in Cutler Ridge, Florida. Along with his two brothers, he was raised by single mother Rosemary Clark. Kevin was a scrapper from a young age, and he got into his first fistfight at the age of 13 while attending Bel Air Elementary School. What started the fight, you ask? Well, his friend was getting bullied, and Kevin jumped in to defend him.
I saw a friend of mine just getting beat up, and I just went over there and intervened.
What a sweetheart.
I enjoy kicking ass.
Now Kevin moved on to Cutler Ridge Middle School and then Richmond Heights Middle School before attending Miami Palmetto High, where he joined the football team. His size, strength, and natural talent made him the school's star linebacker. He might have been an excellent candidate for a college football scholarship, but sadly, that wouldn't be in the cards for young Kimbo.
It's increased in speed a little bit at 16 miles per hour and could very well make landfall somewhere in southern Florida over the next 20 hours or so.
In 1992, Florida was devastated by Hurricane Andrew. Kevin's high school was damaged and the football season was cut short. Now the hurricane also destroyed his house, forcing him to live in his 1987 Nissan Pathfinder. But Kimbo bounced back. He got into Bethune-Cookman University and later transferred to the University of Miami, where he finally secured for himself an athletic scholarship. He even got the opportunity to try out with the Miami Dolphins. But while he made it a part of the preseason squad, he didn't make it onto the team. His career as a football player ended there. Now, more bad news was in store for Kevin when in 2002 he was charged for carrying a concealed weapon. At the time, money wasn't exactly rolling in, so desperate for cash, Kimbo worked a string of odd jobs to pull himself through poverty.
And we all do what we have to do to make a living, you know, and to survive. I would work a job, you know. At those times, you know, people just wasn't hiring.
He washed cars, he drove limos, he worked as a bouncer, and as a bodyguard for a porn production company called Reality Kings. I think we can safely assume Michael is a big fan of their work.
I love you very much.
Around this time, Kevin started doing amateur street fights. The matches were bare-knuckle brawls, often staged in backyards. But they paid the bills. Kimbo would earn $3,000 per victory, and he only suffered one known loss at that time to Boston police officer Sean Gannon. Kimbo's backyard brawls were later posted online and would immediately garner widespread attention.
He'd go on to post 8 fights in all.
racking up a 7-1 record and more than 10 million page hits as web links to his fights flew from email to email.
Retired MMA fighter Bas Rutten was impressed and started training with him. Kimbo also trained with Marcus Avellan, David Avellan, and boxing instructor Randy Kadami. Kimbo's first MMA match was against Olympic gold medalist and WBO heavyweight champion Ray Mercer on June 23, 2007. It wouldn't last long. Slice beat Mercer only 72 seconds into the first round. Joining Elite XC, Kimbo began to translate his internet stardom into mainstream success. He quickly began earning more money than established MMA veterans and competing in main events. But despite his inexperience, he was winning fights against guys like Tank Abbott and James Thompson. In fact, in his first fight with Elite XC, he took Bo Cantrell down in only 19 seconds.
The Kimbo would come in, calm, cool, collected, already a body shot, ripping away at Cantrell.
Oh, yeah.
This one is over.
Kimbo was set to fight Ken Shamrock on October 4th, 2008. But only hours before the match, Ken was injured. Seth Petruzelli was brought in as a last-minute replacement. Although Kimbo received $500,000 to fight him, the match would be an embarrassment for both Kimbo and Elite XC. Seth hinted to the press that the league encouraged him not to take Kimbo to the ground, and Kimbo would nevertheless lose the fight in only 14 seconds.
Kimbo walking in. Look at that. Nice karate push kick. Keeps him out. That short jab hit him in the, right on the eyebrow, and it stunned him. Kimbo went down. And never recovered.
Elite XC would soon file for bankruptcy, but Kimbo's success continued in the UFC. Now, after a couple of lower profile matches, he made his pay-per-view debut at UFC 113 against Matt Mitrione. Unfortunately, he lost the match and retired from the UFC the very next day. Since 2011, Slice tried his hand at boxing. Although his boxing career was pretty short-lived, he did pretty well. He beat James Wade, Tay Bledsoe, Charles Hackman, and Shane Tilliard. 5 years after his departure from UFC, Kimbo signed a multi-fight deal with Bellator MMA. The most anticipated of these bouts would be against Data 5000, a longtime rival of Kimbo's from their street fighting days back in Perrine, Florida.
You got baby nuts, Dada. You got baby nuts. I bet you my nuts bigger than yours.
I hear you.
Come on.
Kimbo won the match after Data collapsed from exhaustion in the third round. But lab results later revealed that Slice had traces of nadrolone, an antibiotic steroid, in his system. He was fined $2,500 and lost his Texas fighting license.
Even guys, before they meet me, will critique me, and they'll do it even after they met me.
Now, short 4 months later, Kimbo was hospitalized in Northwest Medical Center near his home in Coral Springs, Florida. He died just hours later, leaving behind 6 children, a fiance, and millions of fans. And as for the rest of the story, well, it lives on in his legacy, because this is before they were dead. Thanks for watching, you guys. We're still reeling from the shock of Kimbo Slice's sudden departure. Be sure to leave your condolences in the comment section down below. And as always, let us know who you would like to see us document next.
That's one, two. Okay, now here's the third one. Don't let me hit it. Ready?
Yeah. Out of hell.